When we started this journey, we had no idea where it was going to take us. All we had was one simple product, Minecraft. It started as a simple idea. How can I use Minecraft to engage my students and work through social studies? As I opened our textbook, I realized that this wasn't what I wanted, that I wanted these pictures to come alive. And so I jigsawed the chapter and allowed the students to choose a topic to recreate in Minecraft. We started by planning, first on paper, researching our topic, and formulating an idea of what we might be able to build in Minecraft. From there, the students began to work. They took feedback. They gave feedback. They adjusted. They asked for help. They collaborated. It was an amazing thing to watch. Finally, we presented. Sometimes we presented a couple of times. Sometimes we needed to adjust something and then come back to present. But the students that I saw shy before felt confident with their product, were happy to share, and the oohs and the ahs in the crowd was well worth any embarrassment they may have felt when they first started. Originally scrapping a couple of ideas, Jesus decided to do a Tang Dynasty pagoda. This could be one of my favorites. Jesus can be difficult to engage at times, but this project really brought out a side I had never seen before. He was proud of his work, and it looked good. It might sound corny, but the growth that I saw in Santos during this project was immense. He became a leader. The kids came to him and asked him for advice, or asked him for technical help. He became the master builder in our classroom, and I just saw his confidence soar. Santos's level of detail in his project was immense. He actually has each person in line holding a ticket for the ticket booth. One of my favorite features in Minecraft is the ability to actually type out information or sources in your building. Santos also created a throne room for his Forbidden City. In it has an open spot for both the king and queen. While not historically accurate, Santos decided to research Chinese symbols and chose one for the middle of his Forbidden City. Again, the level of detail is crazy. He has full libraries in the basements of his Forbidden City. Jaylene also decided to do the Forbidden City. Her interpretation is very literal, but fantastic. Jaylene did a lot of research and went back and adjusted and came back again to kind of make sure that all the details were right. She really spent a lot of time on the floor and the ceilings with intricate designs. Highland surprised me. Originally starting with the idea of inventions from the Song Dynasty, Highland changed over to the Jinsi Temple and did a fantastic job. I encouraged the kids to use a reference photo that was historically accurate and do a split screen so that they could make sure that they were really building close to what they were trying to do. Jalissa's story is interesting. She originally refused to do the Minecraft, which was okay. I told her she could do a PowerPoint. After losing the PowerPoint save, she decided to try her hand at Minecraft, and she did an excellent job. Jalissa also used a reference photo to recreate Empress Wu's resting place. One of my favorite parts of this project was watching the students ask for help from each other and really collaborating together on how to do certain aspects of Minecraft. Jessica has a hard time communicating verbally and written, but this project really provided her a way of showing her quirky sense of humor, but her amazing build skills at the same time. Jessica's concept was probably the most unique in the classroom. She decided to do a museum for Chinese inventions. Along with it, she created a crazy roller coaster. Inside the museum, she has different pictures representing the different inventions, and then she actually put text next to it from her research. Jessica also recreated different aspects of Chinese architecture. Jessica could be one of the shyest students I've ever met, but this project really gave her the confidence to not only present in front of her peers, but explain her design at the technology showcase to complete strangers. Orlando is a master builder as well, and many of the students would ask him for help, but he struggled to create a plan and implement it. I think he's used to free building, and this was an excellent way for him to practice planning, executing, and finishing a project. One of the best parts of this project was being able to watch the students show off their work at the Southridge Technology Showcase. As different people came to our table, it was great to see students taking charge, showing off their work, being proud of what they had made, being proud of what they had learned, and really showing off how they used Minecraft to create their world.